just don't get it. Somebody has to be here. They had to turn on the lights. Hello? This is ridiculous. I know our meeting was for tonight at 7. I know I was late, but you'd think they'd be here. I just hope they're not a bunch of hicks. Figures you'd be there now. Who are you?
Well, I'd be the main hick. Everybody calls me Sarge.
Well, golly, Sarge. I'm Margot Daly. I'm directing the next show.
Ain't no skin off my nose.
I just thought you'd want to know.
You'd have thought so, wouldn't you?
Where is everybody?
Well, they ain't here.
Well, then I'll stop counting. Sorry, Uber lag. This is the theater, isn't it?
Depends. What day is it?
Friday.
Friday, then yeah, it is.
And what do you do?
About what?
I mean, here.
Oh, well, it's quite crazy. I set up chairs. You see, a chair? It's set up. You think it's magic?
I promised myself I wouldn't get involved.
Listen, Magoo.
Margo.
You sure about that?
I was supposed to meet the Fine Arts Council Board here tonight at 7 o'clock.
That ain't what they told me.
Well, what did they tell you?
They told me to set up chairs.
Somehow I knew that was coming.
Yeah, now listen, because I like you, I'm gonna give you some advice.
Oh, I could feel the chemistry from here.
Yeah, anyways, three things mainly. Number one, you're gonna wanna let everybody else do the talking around here. Eventually they'll tire out and then you can say your piece.
I see.
And the number two is, never be the last one to leave the building. And then number three is, you don't want to listen to a thing anybody says. And then number four would be...
You said three things.
Well, did you hear number three?
Right.
Yeah.
What was I thinking?
Mm-hmm. And number four is, don't tell them we need to build a whole bunch of new scenery.
Why not? Oh, now I know what you do.
Yeah, I'm the guy. I'm the guy they call last minute to build something that they needed yesterday that's over budget to impress a bunch of people that they don't even like and take credit for something they didn't even do.
You don't care much for them, do you?
Oh, what? They's like family.
But not your family.
Exactly.
You're new here, aren't you?
Hello.
All right, well, listen up, City Slicker. We don't need any newcomers coming in here trying to mess things all up. We bring things just the way we like them, and we don't have any new... What?
Hope, this is the nice new lady we hired to direct the show.
Oh! Well, listen up, City Slicker. We don't need anybody coming in here trying to mess things up. We got things just the way we like them, and we don't need any newcomers coming in here and trying to change everything.
I guess I shouldn't have mouthed off like that. Who is that?
Her name's Hope.
You're kidding.
Yeah. And she thought she was going to get to direct the show.
Oh.
Yeah, everybody wants to move people. Ain't nobody want to move furniture. Oh, here comes another one.
Should I know anything about him?
He ain't as friendly as we are.
Maybe I should have brought pepper spray.
It's been done before.
Who is that?
She's the director.
I thought you were going to run her over with her car.
There's still enough time.
Hey. I'm Duncan O'Toole.
Hi, I'm Margot Daly. I'm really looking forward to directing your group.
You're definitely new here. We don't shake hands anymore. It's kind of weird. Have you met everyone?
Just you, Sarge, and Hope there.
Oh. Don't mind Hope. Her bark is worse than her bite. Though I do have teeth marks from last time.
Oh, poor little Duncan. I cried at Frozen.
It was
I
a
cried
sad
Hope
movie.
Bit me. Well, you
do
know
you
what?
Think you could get that Uber thing to come back?
I will now.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, we're going to have lots of fun. You don't need to be worried about this lady before you even meet her. So she's from New York. So what?
She won't like me. I just know she won't like me. They never do. I never make a good first impression.
Oh, honey. It's not your first impression that's the problem.
That's right, sweethearts. After people get to know you, that they don't like you.
You're just trying to make me feel better.
Sure.
And that would be the Fine Arts Council. And from here on out, you're on your own.
right. No. Right, sorry. I apologize for being late. My Uber got here 20 minutes ago. You're Tamara Logan?
Guilty, I'm afraid. I'm the president of the council.
I still demand a recount as per the bylaws.
Oh, don't start that again.
I'm really looking forward to directing your production of Hamlet.
And we're all looking forward to working with you. Right?
Yeah.
Welcome is most heartwarming.
Oh, don't worry about them. Once you get to know them, you'll fit right in. Oh. This is Mary Beth Lumpkin, our secretary.
Hello. Hi. If there's anything I can do for you, please let me know. I really want to help out, and I want you to think of me if there's anything I can do, anything at all. I can be your right-hand man, except I'm a girl, but I can be your right-hand girl if there's anything, okay. Anything at all.
Oh, please, will somebody shut her up, hit her or something?
Just don't fight me again.
Oh, just don't fight me again. Boo-hoo.
So, let's get started.
Now, I want you all to know that I'm not here with any preconceived notions. I want to hear from you with any ideas that you might have. Oh, and I'm not here to change anything. I know that many times in a group... What?
We haven't opened the meeting yet.
All right, not going to change anything, she says, and starts right in on mouthing off. Tamara, who knows what kind of bad habits she brought in from New York? Come on!
Stop it. You're doing fine. You'll get the hang of everything and fit right in. After all, we're not going to bite. Hope!
At least her teeth didn't fall out this time.
These are my teeth,
oh,
Duncan!
Oh, pay good money
at
for
least
our
I can
Will you two stop?
I wish I had a gavel. They promised me a gavel.
Now, I would like to officially call this meeting to order.
Now, again, I want to emphasize that I know I'm new here, but I want you all to know...
No.
No.
Not yet. You're doing fine, though. Just fine.
Mm-hmm.
Fit right in.
You're from New York, huh? The Big Apple.
Well, yes and no.
Huh?
I'm from New York, but not New York, New York. I'm from Buffalo.
So not the Big Apple?
No.
And what's Buffalo? The big chicken wing?
So, we've all read her resume. May we now have a reading of the minutes of the last meeting? Mary Beth?
Mary Beth!
Oh, I'm sorry. Here we are. The meeting of the Fine Arts Council met on April 1st at 7 o'clock. The meeting got underway at precisely 8:45.
My septic tank exploded.
Not everything is relevant, Duncan.
Old business included at the time the purchase of a first aid kit, monies raised to purchase said first aid kit, an investigation into exactly what happened to the monies raised to purchase said first aid kit.
So we have a first aid kit?
No.
Okay.
New business included at the time the hiring of a New York director, Magro Dutton.
That's Margot Daly. Oh,
really? I don't want to have to retype this thing.
Fine. Call me Magro.
Okay. Meeting adjourned after somebody smelled smoke.
Thank you. Now, I would like to officially welcome our newest member to the Peaceful Glen Memorial Players. Shouldn't you be writing this down?
Oh, yeah. Does anybody have a pen?
Oh, I got one. Remember where you got that?
Personal space bubble.
Why are you called the Peaceful Glen Memorial Players? Like, what? Where'd that name come from?
Well, when we got the building, the sign outside already said Peaceful Glen Memorial on it, so we just painted players on it, on the sign, over what was already there, already written on the sign.
Okay, is there an end to that sentence? I got a roast in the oven.
This place was called Peaceful Glen Memorial? That kind of sounds like a funeral
home. That's what it is. Well, what it was before it folded. Before we got it. Before it was donated to us. Now you've got me doing it.
Sorry.
Oh, also, the City Festival Committee still has to meet to decide our theme this year. But don't worry about that. But let us know what it is and plenty of time for our advertising budget.
Wait, where is the advertising budget?
It's probably in the first aid kit.
Hey, wait on a second. This meeting ain't official.
Why?
You're the president, Tamara. You should know the rules.
Oh, not again.
Okay, she's the president?
All right, I know. We all voted for her, except for you.
Okay, well, we cannot start any meeting without old man Donnelly present. You know that.
Oh, she's right. She's absolutely right. I must have been so excited about you coming, I completely forgot. Is Mr. Donnelly here?
Of course he's here. He's always here.
Right. Sarge?
Sarge!
show we work in their names as part of the production.
You put their names in the play?
Yeah. See here. To be or not to be, that is the question. And we were talking about it down at Johansson's Cut and Curl, where the man on the go can look his finest with just a trip, a clip, and a snip. Johansson's, the clip joint to the stars.
And then you go on with the scene. Simple.
In the play?
Oh, just put them anywhere. I'll lift it right in.
He told me Toby Keith.
Oh, no, that was his horse. He trimmed his horse.
We don't need to get into any of that right now.
And they never did prove that it was his horse either, so.
Okay. Polly's Pots and Plates, the Quiche Barn. Cal's Computer Corral, there's a natural for Shakespeare. And Ruck's Pizza Kitchen, you've got to be kidding me.
Well, they donate money if we advertise for them. They like to hear their names said out loud.
In the play? What's that?
No, sweetheart, keep up. The real question here is, who is that?
Oh, who is that?
That's the guy we brought in to direct the last show.
Oh!
Will that be all, Your Grace?
Thank you, Sarge.
People don't know what I have to put up with. Bunch of whiny, self-important.
Oh, I thought that was pretty good. Yeah.
That, Margot, is Archibald Donnelly. You see, as part of his will, we get this building if he's at all the meetings.
So he's... this is his,
That's right. It was a hunting accident. He had just gotten out the dynamite.
I think I want to skip over that story.
He always loved the arts.
And he was the cheapest man in the world.
We shouldn't talk bad about him, now that he's gone, you know.
But he's not gone. He's right here.
In a cheap urn. Look at the size of that thing.
He wasn't all that cheap.
No, he never got anybody anything.
He gave us this building.
Well, he certainly doesn't need it anymore.
What about the time he gave his uncle a kidney?
There you go. Donnelly gave his uncle a kidney. No questions asked?
No, he wanted a lung. Donnelly talked him down to a kidney.
Oh, yeah.
Well, at least he gave up his own kidney.
It wasn't his kidney.
Oh, I think I want to skip over that story, too.
Also, Margo, we're going to need a list from you. Technical things, you know?
Oh, sure. Light cues, props.
When to put up the audience participation signs.
Yes.
Audience participation signs?
Yeah. You know, like cheer, boo, hiss. All that kind of stuff. You don't do that in Buffalo?
No.
Well, it's so the audience will know when to throw the popcorn.
You sell them popcorn so they can throw it at the actors?
No, we don't sell them the popcorn. They bring it we should
Duncan.
Sell them the popcorn.
No.
That's a great idea.
Thank you.
Mary Beth, write that down.
But you weren't that time. Change anything.
Well, right.
Hey,
hey, that worked when I gave it to you. It should be a good one, too. I got it at the post office.
What?
Oh, nothing.
Can't
don't
just
worry.
Steal pens.
I didn't steal.
Anyways, the audience always throws popcorn at the villain. Not at the good guy.
We should sell them something to throw at the good guy.
Duncan, will you sit down? Besides, what can you throw at the good guy?
A brick.
It's just a thought. Who is the good guy in this thing anyway?
It's Hamlet.
Yeah, come on.
Oh.
Isn't it?
Haven't you read this play?
No.
Okay, and she's the president.
Well, have you?
No. But I'm not the president, remember?
How did you even choose this play?
Oh, the same way we do it at the Globe Theater.
We got a hat, and everyone wrote down the names of Joes we knew.
One we'd heard.
And then we put them into the hat, and then we put
I think
one
I get the idea.
The
yeah, we almost
and
ended up doing Avenue Zoo.
Oh, yeah.
Duncan.
Yeah.
Duncan. Did you hear? Duncan.
Okay. You know, ever since you got that subscription to Reader's Digest, you've been obnoxious.
That's not true. She was obnoxious before she got the magazine subscription.
Excuse me?
I have it in the minute.
Has anybody read Hamlet?
Obviously not.
Margot, have you read it?
I mean, yeah, sure. I directed it in Buffalo, remember?
Oh, right. I completely forgot. Well, what can you tell us about him?
Tell you about Hamlet? Okay. What can I tell you about Hamlet? Well, he's erratic, scheming, diabolical, and quite mad. And he'd fit right in.
What?
and I am auditioning for any part that you think that I can handle. I don't really have any theater experience as far as actually being on a stage. However, I once watched them film an episode of Jimmy Fallon, so that's it's gotta count for something, right? No. Also, I don't really have anything prepared per se, so I'm just gonna be reading something from here. So I'll just get straight into that. My lord, I do not know, but truly do I fear it. He took me by the wrist and held me hard. Then goes he the length of all his arm, and with the other hand. Wait. just a second. Found it. He falls to such perusal of my face as he would draw it. Long stayed he so. At last a little shaking of mine arm and thrice. His head waving up and down. He raised a sigh so piteous and profound that it did seem to shatter all his bulk and end his being. Well, that's it. I hope you get the idea of what I can do, and yeah. Oh, and the part that I was reading was that of Ophelia. Thank you.
I'm Zoe Marcus. I can't be here on Tuesdays or Thursday nights, Saturday afternoons, or Sunday evenings. I can't sew, and I have problems with my back, so I can't build anything either. I'm nearsighted, so it wouldn't be a good idea to have anyone throw anything to me during the play. I get motion sickness and have a fear of heights, and certain fabrics make me itch. I don't play men's parts because my shrieks decided a problem with my father. Oh, and I wear special shoes, and I don't work with any types of animals. Dog, cat, parakeet, guppy, don't get them near me. I don't like them. They don't like me, enough said. Other than that, I'm wide open.
I am thy father's spirit, doomed for a certain term to walk the night, and for the day, confined to fast and fires, till the foul crimes done in my days of nature aren't burnt and purged away. But that I am forbid to tell the secrets of my prison house, I could a tale unfold whose lightest word would harrow up thy soul and freeze thy young blood, and make thy two eyes like stars start from their spheres. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm not auditioning, I'm just reading this.
I'm auditioning for the show because I heard there's a lot of battle thing. Is there a lot of swordplay? Because that's what I'm after. I drive a bus at the high school, so I've got a lot of pent-up tension and I could really use an outlet. Just give me a part and any kind of weapon. Battle axe, saber, mace, I'm wide open. I mean it. You want realism? I can give it to you. Just give me a chance.
I am Theodora Van Horn. I'm sure you've heard of me. I've been in Shakespeare since I was a small child. Shakespeare, O'Neill, Jackie Collins, I've done all the classics, darling. But I'm sure I don't have to tell you about my skills on stage. And in each production, I've received rave reviews for my performances. Whenever a critic came out to review the show, that is. And whenever it was a good critic who sat through the entire performance without either falling asleep halfway through or being held later for questioning by the authorities. Oh, and in regards to last year's rap musical production of Butch Minds the Baby, I did not bring that goat. Anyway, just wanted to pop by and say I have an opening in my schedule. Kiss, kiss.
Who ordered the deluxe half mushroom, half anchovy?
Time for us to this so many times before. What's so different about this bunch?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Try me.
Okay, well, you remember the Texas Chainsaw Massacre?
Yeah.
I think I know why he did it.
Hon, it's a community theater. What did you expect?
A community? Or a theater. This is a funeral home.
Oh, I know. They think they're the world's greatest little theater group. Or the world's most talented little theater group.
They're the world's most dangerous little theater group.
You just need to get to know them better, that's all.
Get to know... Let me tell you about these people. Talk about a confederacy of dunces. These people are Looney Tunes.
How do you mean?
Well, first there's a guy named Sarge. Thinks he knows everything and hates everybody. I think he's actually a good guy. Nobody will admit it, but he runs the place. And the others?
What about the others?
Well, take Tamara, the president. She hasn't a clue what she's doing. She tries to run everything, but doesn't know how, and doesn't even know she doesn't know how. And then there's Hope. Talk about somebody who was misnamed. I bet her middle name is Les. She gripes about everything and has never had an unexpressed thought. I think she might sleep in a coffin. And then there's Duncan. All he does is tell these long, pointless stories, which usually end up with somebody either being arrested or dismembered. And last and least, there's Mary Beth, the secretary for the group. Mary Beth is so pitiful. What a mouse. No personality, no incentive. She just sits there like a lump.
Well, everybody has personality flaws, hon. I mean, you can just imagine how these people would feel if they heard what you said about them. If they heard what you said about them.
Listen, I wouldn't dare.
If they heard what you said about them.
I wouldn't dare mention that these are just some of the stories I've heard around town about these wonderful people I'm working with. Not that I believe them, of course.
Of course. They're gone.
Well, golly. Shove me under a couch and call me a dust bunny. Nah, say, I like you.
Shove me under...
And that was Sarge.
Okay.
Chairs you gonna need?
You're going to help me?
Well, don't tell the others.
Your secret's safe with me. Only 5 more chairs. This is going to be a nightmare.
Well, they usually are. Oh, that reminds me. Here you go.
What's this for?
You'll find out.
Nobody's here yet, right?
Depends. What time you call rehearsal?
15 minutes ago.
Oh, you're early then.
I wanted to get a head start on things.
Yep.
Matilda?
Oh, no, no. Sorry. Please don't call me that.
Well, what's your name?
Matilda. My mom's the only one that calls me that, though, so
everybody else calls me Budgie. Okay, well, sit down, Budgie. Here's your script.
Thank you.
What part is mine? Hang on. You're playing Bernardo.
Okay.
And Rosencrantz, Francisco, Fortinbras, a gravedigger, and an actor.
Huh?
You're playing several parts.
Good thing I got a bike.
Everybody is all over. Oh, good, you're here. Let's see. You're
Zoe.
Right? And Opal?
Present.
You'll just take a seat, and this is Budgie.
Budgie? What's that short for?
Matilda. Sarge, you sure I can't talk you into playing a part? I'm talking cash here. Or maybe a large pizza?
Oh, I couldn't. My insurance don't cover this place. Oh, what am I saying? Their insurance don't cover this place.
I hope I get lots of action. I really need to work off a lot of energy.
My dad needs his garage painted.
Weren't you the one who delivered a pizza to my house last Thursday? Super deluxe, double cheese?
Yeah.
It was cold when it got there.
Well, there's a very good reason for that.
And that is?
It was cold when I got it.
Oh, am I late?
You mean by normal standards or here?
Here?
Well, you're here. That's all that matters. I have this theory about it. When it's 7:30 in New York, it's 1954 here. Take a seat.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello.
Hi.
Yeah, hi.
I've never done any of Shakespeare before. Have any of you?
I've never done anything before.
I once saw Hamlet with Mel Gibson.
No kidding. Did he, like, sit next to you, or?
You're gonna be trouble, aren't you? Good. I like trouble.
Where's the cast list? What parts are we playing?
I think I'm doing the entire first act.
I am here. I have come. I have, in every sense of the word, arrived. No. No need to get up for me.
Wasn't planning on it.
And she's the one with experience.
On stage?
Well, that too. Anyways, you guys just gonna be out here?
Right.
Then I'll be back there.
Margot, my dear, I have some absolutely fabulous ideas for the performance. If you're open to suggestions, you are open-minded, aren't you? Yes, of course you are. All great directors are, you know. That is what makes them great. The ability to reach for that inspiration, seize it, and run with it. We are all students here. The muse speaks, and we must listen. Are these not your intentions, your feelings on the matter? You must be brutally frank with me.
Can I get a sword now?
Doesn't she run that blacksmith shop at the end of Commerce?
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, sure. How about you take a seat and we can get started, shall we?
Yeah, didn't mean to hold up rehearsal or anything, but sometimes I get a feeling, and I want you all to share that feeling with me. Is that not what makes an individual into a group, a team, are sharing with each other each and every day, each and every feeling?
You're the ham, aren't you?
The what?
Last Saturday night, I delivered a super pizza to your house. Double ham?
Oh, right. That's correct. You're very quick.
Not if you want it hot.
Okay, that's why
that was the best.
Okay, I can see we're all getting to know each other, so how about let's get started. Now, a bit about the play. One of the greatest works ever written for the English stage.
And I want you all to know that I have been working on my accent.
You don't have an accent.
He's been working on it.
I mean for the play. I did some research.
But it's in English.
Yeah, but I've been working on this accent here, no?
What was that?
Well, I read that Hamlet is from Denmark. That is the way they all talk. To be or not to be, eh? That is the question.
You just did like 5 accents. Well, anyway, we're just gonna do it without the accents, so.
Oh, man. I spent $20 on those downloads.
Good feeling, though. Could you shared it with all of us. Shows that you're a very warm and caring person. Probably.
Okay. Now let's get started. I think you all should know that we will be crossing the gender lines for this show. Men and women?
So you mean we're dressing together?
No.
I think I should get my own dressing room. After all, there's 6 of us.
Yeah, I want my own dressing room.
Does this mean that I have to, like, wear a dress?
Okay, I mean, since there are more men than women in the play, and more women
guy.
Several small guys.
At one time?
That's gonna make it hard for the sword fights.
Will you forget about the sword fights? Now, if there's no further objection, I'll finish assigning the parts.
Is that a
I got it.
I don't want to know. You're awfully handy with that extinguisher.
Well, yeah. We gotta subscribe and save the Amazon. Folks.
What is that?
The Amazon?
There's no fire. It's fine.
Are you sure?
Yeah, just let's get started for real this time.
Yeah, I feel it.
Okay, so I want you all to read for the part of Hamlet.
What?
The lead?
I don't think I can fit him in.
Margot, my dear, you are an inspiration to us all. Me, mostly. Shakespeare, as it was originally performed.
I don't think I'll have time to learn that many lines.
Listen, I just came to get my feet wet. You know, just sort of work my way
into the
room.
I don't get it. Are we going to be playing several parts at the same time or what?
Just give me a foil and I'll do whatever you want.
No, I think we all need to do our utmost to support our gifted director here.
I mean,
you guys are playing my ideas.
Ladies
and gentlemen, may I present Hamlet?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, let's get started.
Aye, Mary, why was he sent into England? How came he mad? How strangely?
Not yet.
Upon what grounds? How long must a man lie in the earth ere he rot?
Oh, we cut that line.
Seriously. Oh.
Why is he more than another? More than another?
Now? How come he asks all these questions and nobody answers him?
He's mad.
Well, he ought to have to squat back here for about an hour.
Okay, what's your line?
Hang on. Are you through?
Go ahead.
Okay. A pestilence upon him for mad rogue. Oh, yep, he's mad. Cecil right here.
Yep, I've read it. Go ahead, you're doing fine.
Really? I'll go ahead. This same skull, sir, was Yorick's skull, the king's jester. Who's playing Yorick?
He's dead.
Well, good thing nobody's playing him.
You're in a graveyard.
Really? Oh, yep, it says graveyard right here. Yorick's skull, the king's jester.
Now hold up the skull.
I hold up a skull?
You hold up a skull.
Like, a real skull?
What difference does it make?
Well, we have to bring in a lot of the stuff for the play ourselves. Where am I gonna get a skull?
We'll get you a skull.
Well, for right now, I don't have a skull.
Pretend you have a skull. And I mean that in every sense of the word.
Okay. The king's jester.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio. A fellow of infinite jest.
Well, he was a jester.
You don't have a line. That's not in the play.
Well, I threw that in, okay? We need some laughs in here.
It's not a comedy.
Well, then how come everybody back there is giggling so much?
Oh, my.
Knock it off back there. I'm in a graveyard for crying out loud.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio. A fellow of infinite jest, of most excellent fancy. He hath borne me on his back 1,000 times. Here, hung those lips which I have kissed.
Yuck.
Where are your jibes now? Your gambols, your songs, your flashes of merriment?
So- Sarge, could you stop your hammering? Try it again.
Where are your jibes now? Your gambles, your...
Sarge?
What?
Could you stop your hammering?
Oh, you mean that. Okay, Mrs. Blankton! Oh, that's just Mrs. Blankton. She lives in the basement apartment.
Somebody lives below here?
Yeah, she came with the building.
And she does that whenever we get too loud?
Uh-huh. That's why during the performances, we buy her a bus ticket to go visit her sister.
Break! Okay, let's just read through the scene and I'll show you what to do.
You betcha. I'll drop it.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
You must translate his bid, we understand. Where is your son?
Bestow this place on us a little while. Ah, my good lord, what have I seen tonight?
What, Gertrude? How does Hamlet?
Mad as the sea and the wind, when both contend, he whips his rapier out and cries, a rat!
What?
A rat!
Where? Those are her lines!
Where is it?
It's nothing.
Somebody saw a rat. I heard him.
It's in the play. You brought a bat for a rat?
Well, yeah. You should have seen the last one. Right in the middle of the Oprah Winfrey special, too.
Oprah was here?
Okay, just keep going.
And in this brainish apprehension kills the unseen good old man.
Oh, heavy deed. It had been so with us had we been there. His liberty is full of threats to all. How shall this bloody deed be answered? It will be laid to us.
Oh, okay. Good idea here. When she finishes her speech, the part ending with, in this brainish apprehension kills the unseen good old man, Lamar, you pick up the queen in your arms. Take it from, he whips his rapier out. Oh, and don't scream, rat.
I am your slave.
Whatever. Go.
He whips his rapier out and cries, a rat. A rat. And in this brainish apprehension kills the unseen good old man.
Oh, heavy deed. It would have been so with us had we been there. His liberty is full of threats to all. How shall this bloody deed be answered? Oh, it'll be late tomorrow. Oh, my gosh.
Are you okay?
Have you ever thought about getting a gym membership?
What could you possibly mean by that?
I'm sorry.
Break. Opal, get out here. Okay, no. Let's put that down. Okay. So, you're going to enter, cross to Hamlet, kneel down, and say your line. Your lordship is right welcome back to Denmark. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. Get the horse, and then go. Stop.
What?
What is that?
You said grab the horse, but this is all I could find.
Fine. It'll fit right in.
Your lord is shipped right back to Den... No, that's not it.
The back of your lordship is... That's not it either. Your lordship is welcomed right to the den. I'll get it. Your lord is the Denmark, yeah. We welcome your lordship to Denmark, right?
Just say,
welcome back, Hamlet.
Okay.
And this play has 5 acts.
You're telling me.
Welcome back, Helmet.
Hamlet, it's the name of the play, you idiot. How could you forget the name of the play?
How many guys do you know named Hamlet?
How many guys do you know named Helmet?
Good point.
Break. That is it. That is the final straw. This is insane. This is absolute madness. You people are driving me crazy.
Maybe you should play Hamlet.
Shut up! All of you! We've been rehearsing for 4 days now and we're losing ground. We're barely where we were before we even met. She's at bingo! This is impossible!
Margot?
What?
Your lordship is right. Welcome back to Denmark.
Yes!
That's lovely, Opal.
Thank you.
It's not you. It's not any of you. It's just this whole setup. I mean, Hamlet with 6 actors? I must have been out of my mind to even think we could pull this off. It means I'm through.
No,
I can't leave. You're the best friend.
This has all been really nice, but I just cannot do it. I'm gonna go back to my garage apartment, empty the cockroaches out of my suitcase, pack up my clothes, and what's left of my sanity, and just as fast as I can, I'm going home.
Well, looks like I got here just in time.
Yes, you did. Tamara, I'm sorry, but I can't do this show.
We heard. We could hear you all the way downtown. I'm surprised Mrs. Boynton hasn't wrapped on the floor yet.
It's Thursday.
Oh, that's right, bingo night.
You didn't tell me about her, did you?
No, that's why we're here.
We?
Yes, us. Everybody?
This is where the party is?
Come on, shove out the box for this.
I hope we didn't keep everyone waiting.
Well, folks, looks like Margot is having a bit of a rough time. That's why we had another meeting.
Is anybody hurt?
Now listen, we got together and we changed a rule. The rule where council members are not allowed to participate in a production. In other words, can you use former actors?
Can you use us?
You did that for me?
Well, there you go, hon. Now you have 10 actors.
I just don't know what to say.
Oh, just tell us what parts you want us to play, dear. We're all yours.
What light through yon window breaks?
Somebody broke a window?
Take nothing! No.
So will you stay?
Please.
Well, I guess so.
Yes!
And thank you. Thank you all.
You're welcome. Now, have you folks had a break? We got some food back here.
There's food!
Sorry.
I really thought I was at the end of my rope, but then you people did this? It's just the sweetest thing.
Oh, don't think anything of it, dear.
So, you feel better about the place?
from day one. I could think of it as a saber. I got it in the cavalry. Cavalry. Fine, it'll fit right in. It'll fit right in? I'm starting to talk like you now.
Oh, some of your actors may not know this, but during the beginning of the play, they really need to talk loudly.
I told them to project.
Whatever. For the first 15 minutes or so, you're going to hear a lot of the audience sucking on their fingers.
What?
It's the barbecue. It's really disgusting.
You just had to serve ribs, right?
We give them what they like.
That's how they do it at the Globe Theater.
You keep saying that, but they do not sell barbecue at the Globe Theater in England.
What do you mean, England? I'm talking about that Mennonite group over in Jefferson, the Globe Theater.
Anybody seen my skull?
No.
She's right, Hope. Their last show, they didn't serve barbecue. They served fish sticks. Remember?
Oh, right. And all the tartar sauce went bad.
Oh, yeah. You should have heard that audience at the beginning of that show.
Oh, Jolly Horse! Oh, Jolly Horse!
Walk it off.
Oh.
Does anybody know if the critic is here?
There's a critic?
Yeah, Helen Dormonger. She rents a feed and fertilizer store.
Critic and fertilizer saleswoman?
Like there's a difference?
Has anybody seen my skull?
No.
No. You look great.
Oh, thanks.
Where'd you get the whiskers?
Oh, it's my mom's wig.
What's your mom wearing?
I didn't think of that.
Did it run in here?
What?
Oh, nothing. As you were.
That's concerning.
What ran in here?
Hey, Margo. About the part where I play the ghost of Hamlet's father.
Yeah. What about it?
What's my motivation?
Your what?
What's the subtext there?
Now, Zoe, I told you not to read anything, didn't I?
Yeah,
but...
Oh, come on, Margo. They use subtext all the time at
the Globe Theater. Yeah, I heard.
Okay, Snippy.
Leo, is the critic here yet?
Oh, Dortmunger can't be here. We have smelled her by now.
Over the barbecue?
Has anybody seen my skull?
No!
Watch out!
Found your skull.
What?
Alas, poor York.
Sarge! Need a repair!
Give me that. Miss Dinstitch is gonna have my hind.
The biology teacher? Well,
she loaned me that. She'll probably replace it with mine now.
What is it?
Got a little skullduggery over here.
Is this all of it?
Not really. I got an awful lot of teeth here.
Give me that. I'll take care of it.
We need this ASAP.
Well, as usual, I am ASAP. So, I'll get her fixed right up.
And everybody remember, party after the show.
Are we having really? Pizza again?
No.
Probably. But it'll be fine.
Pizza.
I love pizza.
Margo?
What? Holy smokes!
Wow!
You look like the Marlboro Man.
Somebody say smoke?
No smoke. It's just an expression. Now fix my skull, will you?
Actors. This is Hamlet.
What have I gotten you into?
Feel like the Surrey with the fringe on top.
Like the awning over at the Western Store.
No, turn around.
Hey, what's the name of that place anyway? Oh, yeah, Saddles and Syrup.
Don't you mean Saddles and Stirrup?
No, I mean Saddles and Syrup. It's a combination pancake house and riding academy. You can actually eat on the horse. Don't try to eat the horse, though. Don't forget to work their name into the show.
Yep, it's taken care of. Don't move too fast. The fringe flails out and makes you look like Reba McEntire.
Take any pictures of the show. I will personally burn them.
Hey, Duncan, don't you go to that place? Saddles and Syrup?
Well, I used to, until I got kicked by one of the horse waiters.
Okay, you're starting to make this stuff up now, aren't you?
You're never gonna know.
Okay, everyone come on in for a quick meeting. Come on, we only have 5 minutes.
Hey, I think I'm just gonna play the king with the limp.
Oh, honey, don't pad your part.
Remember, I told you, you're no longer King Claudius. You're Claude King, Cattle Baron.
Leo, how does the house look?
You know, I still don't see people in the Old West using words like thou and prithee. Yes,
yeah. Well, just stick a y'all in every chance you think of it. Wait, where's Mary Beth?
Oh,
Mary Beth.
I forgot she existed.
over here?
Leo? He's in the bathroom. I don't think he's feeling too good.
He had the barbecue.
It's the tartar sauce all over again! Tomorrow!
Okay, calm down. Now everyone listen up. I know you're all a little nervous, but don't worry about that. Even the best actors get nervous.
Then we should be panic-stricken.
Just do the best you can. You'd be surprised what you're capable of once you get in front of an audience. Mm-hmm. The audience is our guests, and you are their guides, their teachers. Mm-hmm. You are showing them the eloquence and genius that is William Shakespeare. Mm-hmm. You are displaying a craft, an art born of a long time ago. You're transporting them by your acting and by your portrayals out of their everyday humdrum existence into another world. And I can only think of two words to tell you. My last direction to guide you at this time. Don't stop.
What?
Wait, what is that?
I don't care if you forget a line or miss a cue. Keep going.
What if we forget what parts we're playing?
Oh,
keep going.
What if there's a fire?
Yeah. Sarge is used to it. Keep going.
What if our skull is shattered?
Really?
Wait. What?
It's nothing. Don't worry about it. Keep going. Now, is everyone ready?
Sure.
Okay. Leo's back in the booth now, so everyone go to your opening places.
Thank you,
places.
I don't know where I'm supposed to be.
I think
no.
Sarge, please fix my skull.
No.
Oh, Duncan!
Come on, this way. Let's go.
Everything is going to be great.
Uh-huh.
We'll be fine, hon. Don't worry.
I hope so. Leo? Leo.
What?
Remember the final line. Duncan says, but let the same be presently performed. Got that? When Duncan says, let the same be presently performed, that ends the play and you kill the lights.
I got it. You think I'm an idiot?
Do you want a show of hands? What is it, dear?
I'm scared.
We're all scared, dear. And if the audience knew what was in that barbecue, they'd be scared too.
But
just say your lines and you'll be fine.
But how?
Like it says in the play, speak the speech, I pray you, as I pronounce it to you, trippingly on the tongue.
I don't even know what that means.
I pray you, as I pronounce it to you, trippingly, on the tongue. For if you mouth it as many of your players do, I'd life the town crier spoke my lines. Y'all. Nor do not soar your hands in the air too much like thus. But use all gently. Oh, it offends me to the soul to hear a robustious, periwig-pated cowpoke, tear a passion to tatters. Be not too tame neither, but let your own discretion be your tutor.
And that excellent tutor would be?
Chloe Humphmeyer, who teaches piano on weekdays, specializing in the classics. She's the one to meet for all your keyboard needs. Located at the corner of Platt and Farmer, she's also available for weddings.
Oh, reform it altogether. And let those who play your clowns speak no more than is set out for them.
Howdy!
How now, sir? Will Claude King, my stepfather, be hearing this piece of work?
And your mama, the cat or queen, too. And that presently.
Players, I bid you. Make haste.
Yes, verily we shall skedaddle on the horse he rode in on.
My dear Horatio, there is a play tonight before Claude King. conceit of which comes near to the circumstances which I have told thee of my father's death. Now, 'tis true, I'll have grounds more relative than this, but the play is the thing wherein I'll capture the conscience of the king. Now, I prithee, when thou seest that act afoot, observe my uncle, the cattle baron. Give him heedful notice.
I will gaze upon him as if he were fried chicken. The good kind.
Whatever. They're coming to the play. I must be idle. Get you a place.
Oh.
How fares it, cousin Hamlet?
Excellent. Guide you to a place where you may witness the play? Are the players ready?
Oh.
Are the players ready?
Come hither, my good Hamlet, and sit by me.
No, good mother, there is metal more attractive.
Pray, carry me to my seat.
Verily, my queen, you have forgotten my, condition.
How you jest!
Oh, the jolly horse! Oh, it's back!
My lord!
Oh, my God!
Oh, it's your old horse!
Oh, my leg!
Uncle, what is it?
It's a square dance, obviously. Josie, no, around we go! Grab your partner, go!
You're only jig-maker. What must a man do to be merry?
What must these mortals be?
What?
That's all I can think of.
Other way! Switch partners! Round and round! Josie, no!
My stepfather's conscious sounds as if some rapping.
Oh, tapping at my chamber door. 'Tis a visitor, quoth the raven, nevermore.
What are you doing?
'Tis but a poor substitute.
Oh, I gotta get off this thing.
No. I shall attend to my husband. Save my wife!
You don't. We are left to our own devices.
If thou hast an idea, I suggest that we trot it out now.
Let us hide thee to the nearby graveyard that I may gather my wits.
Lead on, Macduff.
Oh, it's Hamlet.
Oh, Hamlet.
Ah, the grave and the grave maker. Has this fellow no feeling of his business? Ah, the grave and the grave maker. Has this fellow no feeling of his business?
Custom hath him a property of easiness.
Y'all.
What? Verily.
Oh. We have come as visitors, come from abroad.
Aye, Mary, why was he sent into England? How came he mad? How strangely? Upon what grounds? How long must a man lie in the earth ere he rot? Why is he more than another? Skull.
Oh. This same skull was York's skull. The king's, Claude King's just sidekick?
Let me see it.
Oh. Oh. Excuse me, sire. It seems that I have lost my head. I shall return anon.
A nun? He's gonna join a convent?
Let us while away a brief, and I mean brief, moment ere he returns.
So,
occurrence of past events. My uncle has slain my father to usurp his power. And my mother.
Ye old instant replay.
But it will be his undoing, mark me. And soon we shall proceed.
From your mouth to God's ears.
There's something rotten in the state of Denmark.
Let us not order the cheese or the tartar sauce.
Wouldst thou something would occur?
What ceremony be here? 'Tis a funeral.
Careful what thou wishes for.
Laertes?
He jumpeth the gun.
Yeah, no, no.
Oh, woeful time! My sister, Ophelia, dead there before us. Lay her in the earth. A ministering angel shall my sister be. Hamlet, the devil take thy soul. Oh. Feel the vengeful edge of my saber, which I got in the Calvary.
Cavalry!
I will revenge the death of my sister, my mad Ophelia!
She hasn't died yet.
Oh, I'll come back. Wait! I, Ophelia, am arrived. I am not feeling in the pink of late.
The fair Ophelia has indeed given way to her madness.
Babbling like a brook she is.
You could say that.
Lead me to my grave that I may shuffle off for something. Ophelia, my sister, I thought you was a goner.
She is on her last legs already.
There's Mrs. Plankton when you need her.
Oh, heat, dry up my mind. Burn out thy sense and virtue of my brains. And with this last refrain, I die.
That again.
Not really.
Okay. Now, sir, prepare to meet the devil himself.
Here he comes now.
This same remains was Yorick's. This grave shall have a living monument. There, Claude King's sidekick.
Alas, poor York. What the?
It's old man Donnelly.
What a trooper.
Sir, I speak, please. Do not return the same artifact into the hands of the grave maker.
Huh?
He is trembling of hand and hath fingers of butter.
There's method to your madness.
I heard that.
'Tis true, 'tis not.
He had the point.
I want you to know that I have carried many such parcels in my time. Some of deluxe size, deep dish and large with pepperoni and anchovies. And never once did I fumble the delivery.
That's southtours.com, open till 10 p.m. every night in the summer.
Let us not go into that now. We have plots to unfold.
And your plot be one next to my sister!
Sure, in a minute.
Make him take it back!
No. What?
He hath made sport of me!
Stand and face me, sir!
Sweets to the sweet, farewell!
Not yet!
Really?
Yeah.
I speak only that thou didst lop said skull into yon perimeter. It went sailing slack-jawed into the wings.
Yes, and would it have had wings, it could have recovered and saved us this awkward scene.
Then I shall retrieve its shattered remains, and then see where you shall be.
Do what thy will, and be off.
Yes, and let the same be presently performed.
What?
And let the same be presently performed.
Oh, what?
I just said the line
what
to
line?
End the show.
Ah,
Leo just heard the line and he ended the show.
Line,
Duncan!
Only.
Oh, my.
jaws of life, and next thing I knew, somebody was shaving my legs. Of course, it was nothing like tonight, right?
Yeah.
How?
We
certainly did.
What a show.
Mm-hmm.
I can't believe we've done it. We played Hamlet.
And Hamlet lost.
Did you guys see the scene where I gouged the castle guard?
Did I see it? I wasn't even a castle guard. I was the ghost of Hamlet's father.
Whatever. We killed a ghost.
I thought I was the ghost of Hamlet's father.
We certainly had them, did we?
But
didn't we leave something out? It seems like there were more lines.
It was live theater, my dear king. Where anything can go wrong.
Yeah, but didn't it though, and like, a lot?
But we overcame it. We all did our best and worked in earnest to excel and to achieve brilliance. And we succeeded!
This has to be the best show we've ever done.
Oh, definitely the best show I've ever done.
Hey, where's Hal? Hal? Oh, there you are. Okay.
You sorry you called me Butterfinger.
Well, thanks to you, old man Donnelly did get to play a part.
Don't bring it up.
And I thought the sock puppet was a stretch.
It was.
Compared to this.
Donnelly was great.
But it's all right. Weren't you supposed to have a line in there? To be or not to be, that is the, whatchamacallit. What happened to that?
It kind of got lost in the shuffle.
That's fine. I thought it slowed up the action too much.
Are you serious?
It was all a triumph.
And who do we have to thank for it but our creative director and guiding light, Margot?
Yes, Margot, please.
You're not going.
No.
When you speak of this, and you will, be kind.
What can I say? We just performed Shakespeare's Hamlet, a play in 5 acts that usually takes about 3 hours in just over 47 minutes.
And Leo said the audience stayed for the whole thing.
Really? Nobody's laughing.
That's never happened.
He said they all stayed.
I am so writing this in my diary. It started out all right. It looked like Hamlet. And then, somewhere, somehow, we segued into Act 4. And then things got confusing. We somehow managed to go back to Act 2, where I distinctly remember hearing the words Rolex watch and Oldsmobile mentioned. And then we went back to Act 5. It was like we were doing Hamlet in flashbacks.
The best way to do it.
That's what she
means. There you all are.
Oh.
Helen!
Oh, it's the critic.
No.
I saw it. I saw it all. But I just don't believe it. I'm absolutely flabbergasted.
Huh?
Are you the director?
Yeah.
Of course. I can see it from here. The play. Well, the production. What can I say? It was astounding. It was thrilling. It was so wonderful. All the splendor, all the pomp and circumstance. It was, well, what can I say? It was the first time I ever understood Hamlet. The opening, stilted at first, but for a reason. We saw the regiment, the traditional protocol of the court set, in a sort of abstract motif against the Old West. But when all seemed to go against itself, the twisting and concentric circles of the scenes, replaced and appearing as if thrown together, here we saw what the madness looked like to Hamlet. It made no sense to us as it made no sense to him. We grappled, we strained to find meaning and substance, but there was none. Characters seemed to appear out of thin air. They seemed to be making up the play as they went along. The essence of the power of Shakespeare. It jumped, it bumped, it jolted, it bolted, and it rode off in all directions. And it ended, abruptly. No questions answered, no conflicts resolved. We are left, as in life, to deal with it all. Left to return to our own unresolved lives. And with Hamlet arguing with the gravemaker? Such imagery. Bad statement that we all end up arguing metaphorically with the gravemaker. It was a pastiche, a testament of man's inhumanity to man, of cruel fate, and of the portrayal, of the betrayal of Hamlet, as seen through his eyes. It was magnificent.
Hi, Helen.
So, did she like it or what?
Yes! Of course she did. Margot, you
tell them that everything was terrible? Were you going to tell them that they were terrible? Were you going to point out every little mistake that they made?
I don't have that many years left, and tonight aged me about 10 years alone.
You can't, Margo. You can't tell them that.
Are you going to stand there and try to tell me it was a good show?
No, but I'm going to stand here and try to tell you that it was a success.
Tonight, this...
Hamlet is supposed to be a tragedy. And it was.
How?
Now look, you gave these people what they believed was a unique experience, an exciting event in their lives. And look at them. They're reveling in it. And now, can you turn around and tell them that it was stupid, that it was all stupid, and that they were stupid to have loved it so?
But it stunk.
Not to them. They accomplished something. It was a success.
But it stunk.
This will go down as a hallmark in their little theater history. I promise you, it was a success.
But it stunk.
Look, think of it this way. They can only get better from here. The only way to go is up.
But I'm the director. I'm the one responsible.
And they love you for it. Besides, I'm sure this is just the way they did it at the Globe.
Yes, but anyone who knows anything about Shakespeare that was here tonight, they saw my name on the program.
Your name? That's what you're worried about?
Wouldn't you be?
Here. I took this for a souvenir.
I don't want it.
Just read it.
The Peaceful Glen Memorial Players proudly present Hamlet, directed by Magro Dutton.
Margo, that call, was it anything important?
No, not at all.
Oh, good. Because we've all decided we want you to direct our next show.
Yeah. Yes, we'll even give you a race.
With extra sauce, too.
What?
Pizza? Come on, you just got there, boy. You can't leave now.
What do you say?
Well, I suppose so.
Yes! And we want you to do the same glorious job you did tonight on our next production.
Oh, I will be sure to do better than that.
Better than that? She's a perfectionist. Love that!
Yes.
Yep, we'll sure give her a try. As sure as my name is Magro Dutton.
Wonderful, Magro. Our next production is going to be a musical.
No, it's not.
Wait, I thought we were doing Cats.
Well, we are, but we're not going to shell out for the music.
Oh, of course.
Frugal. We're doing Cats without the music.
It's creative.
Yeah.
It's
going
to
be wonderful.
It'll be great fun, dear.
So, what do you guys think we'll have to do for an audition?
Well, can anybody bark?
Well, I can bark.
Ruff!
That was really good.
There are no dogs in Cats.
Why not?
We need a bad guy for the people to throw popcorn at.
Yeah, I'm not making popcorn out
of
here.
Do you think I'll get to carry a sword again?
Maybe they'll give you a whip.
Oh,
nice!
Upgrades!
I got it.